first and 10. Wants it all. Deep over the middle for Winicky. Has it inside the 10. Still with it. Diana Powerball. Ilfil Velez on the run. Diving in the alley.
It's Alexander with a nice move. Goes to the rim. Got it to go.
Hi, friends, and welcome to the Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam. Great to have you with us this week. Highlights of men's and women's basketball Summit League competition on the way. Plus, we have a pair of sophomore student athlete spotlights on two excellent individuals who have made their names nationally. Coming up later in the show, we'll look at men's basketball forward Mike Dahm. But we start with the 133-pounder from the wrestling team who is ranked number 2 in the nation. Here's a closer look at Seth Gross.
There are certain moments that define an athlete's career. Friday, February the 3rd, 2017, was one of those for Seth Gross. The 133-pounder walked onto the Frost Arena mat for the final match of the night. 15th-ranked Oklahoma led the 19th-ranked Jackrabbits 19-13, meaning Gross needed a pin to give SDSU any chance to win. The odds seemed rather large, but not to Gross. Just 2 minutes and 24 seconds into the match, he secured a cradle and pinned Trey Blackwell's shoulders to the mat, sending his coach and the large yellow and blue clad crowd into hysterics. Moments later, after adding up the dual match points, SDSU was awarded the victory based on criteria, a defining moment for Seth Gross. But that is not the ending of the story, and it certainly is not the beginning. Gross grew up in the Minneapolis suburb of Apple Valley, and he won 3 consecutive Minnesota State wrestling titles, doing so in 3 different weight classes.
I mean, I guess I'd say the one thing harder than winning a state title is winning another one, I guess. But yeah, it gets harder, and you feel a little bit of pressure after the first one. But then going up weight classes wasn't really too big of a deal, just because I was growing a lot and still was good size at all the weight classes, so.
Gross won 2 cadet national freestyle championships and a junior national title while in high school. Heavily recruited, he chose the University of Iowa. Gross redshirted the 2014-15 season, but shortly after the year was over, he made some mistakes that led to his departure from Iowa, something he takes responsibility for.
After I got in trouble, I think the thing that was hardest on me is I'm pretty big in my faith, and I'm pretty outspoken Christian before this happened and now still. And when that happened, I had a lot of people just kind of dogging on me. Like, that was really tough on me, you know, just because that's something I really dedicated my life to living for God, and when that happens, obviously it doesn't look very good.
And Gross admits he even considered giving up the sport.
I didn't even know if I was going to wrestle after being at Iowa, so I moved home. I was working in the summer, all that, and just didn't know what I was going to do, really.
Friends and family convinced Gross to give wrestling one more try. So he reached out to a handful of coaches, including SDSU's Chris Bono.
I emailed him, and within a couple, like 5-10 minutes, he emailed me back saying, hey, let's get you on campus.
Of course, I do a little searching and realized, you know, he was at the University of Iowa. Something must have been pretty good in his resume. And you know, we're at the point where we're still looking for kids to make an impact on our program. So yeah, of course, I reached back out and wanted to see what he wanted to talk about.
Couldn't be more appreciative. I thank God every day for, I mean, it's amazing. I mean, I couldn't be happier in the place I am right now. So it's amazing. And yeah, like I said, I can't thank God enough and thank Bono enough.
Last year, Gross wrestled at 141 pounds and won 26 matches, reaching the Big 12 championship. He had his hand raised 3 times at last year's NCAA championships, falling 1 win shy of All-America status. An experience that has motivated him into this year.
After last year, a lot of the matches that I did lose, that I was losing last year, were because I was kind of scared to get my offense going in my wrestling matches. I kind of sat back, wrestled not to lose instead of just trying to score points. And I started realizing that last year at the end of the year and kind of picked it up.
He's made a heck of an improvement between last year and this year, just for the fact that competing all summer and going down a weight class, he's really wrestling at the weight class he should be.
This year, I've really just been trying to go out there and score as many points as I can early on and just dominating dudes instead of trying to keep it close and just win a match. So I think that's really helped me this year.
So it is a learning experience. You got to remember, this kid's still only 20 years old. He's had a lot of wrestling experience, but not at this level. This is only his second full season of competing. So, hopefully that lesson has been learned.
It certainly seems like it has. Gross entered the week ranked second in the nation in the 133-pound weight class. He's 23-1 with 10 pinfall victories. In fact, only 8 of his matches have gone the full 7 minutes. And of course, there was that moment last week in Frost Arena when Gross's walk-off pin led SDSU past Oklahoma.
You don't get that opportunity very often, and when you do, how many times do you capitalize on it? It was a storybook setting. It does. I've been involved in the sport a long, long time, and I've never been a part of something like that.
I'd wrestled this kid 2 times last year, and I remember that he was hard to turn, and I beat him both times, but I couldn't really turn him too good or pin him or anything like that, so I was nervous.
I didn't say anything to him when he came running out. I shook his hand, told him to have fun. He's a student of the game.
Ended up, he put his knee a little close to his head, and I was able to lock in a cradle quick and bring him back, so it was awesome. One of the best feelings I've ever been, or best things I've ever been a part of, so it was fun.
Yeah, it doesn't get any better than Friday night, you know? I mean, to beat a team that's ranked higher than you, a program that's got a heck of a tradition behind it, a program that's got some great wrestlers on it, some great coaches, and to do it in front of our fans who, as we can tell this year, are really craving success. The more success we're having, the more they're turning out.
I was going crazy. I remember I smacked the mat, I was clapping. I ran over and hugged the coaches, and the crowd was awesome. Going out there, walking out there, it was awesome. It felt special, you know, just all those people cheering and stuff. And then after we won, it was so loud in there. And I've watched a few videos of it, and like the microphones, you can't even hear anything because the crowd's so loud. It was awesome.
A legendary moment as part of a tremendous season so far. But the goal for both the wrestler and his coach is twofold: All-American and national champion.
I mean, the only thing that's really important for is seeding at nationals, and I want to be a national champ, so to do that, I got to beat anybody anyway, so it doesn't really matter.
I'm hoping he capitalizes on his moment in March in St. Louis on a big blue mat in front of 20,000 people. That's the next moment we're hoping he capitalizes on.
And we hope you'll join us at Frost Arena this week to see Gross and the rest of the SDSU wrestling team in action. Highlights of men's and women's basketball inside the Summit League from the past week coming up after we take you on a trip inside state.
Thanks to SDSU, I'm ready to take on the world. I think I'm ready to go out into the world of pharmacy and make an impact and help change lives. My name's Christian Kroll, and I'm originally from Orinoco, Minnesota, which is right north of Rochester, Minnesota. I've got to kind of expand and look and say, oh, there's a lot more to pharmacy than just this. So definitely giving me more options and more ideas of what I could do for the rest of my life. I love the Honors Hall personally. I got to live there for 2 years, and I love the style of rooms that they have. I love the community that you build there. Our honors classes are a great deal. No matter what class you go into, they're gonna be smaller, and you get priority registration, which is nice as well. I still have connections from the professors in my honors courses to this day for my freshman year. So I've been a big part of intramurals. I've done volleyball and basketball and basically everything. And I've also been a big part of the tutoring program. That's been my big one. So I've been a tutor for the chemistry programs, anatomy, and pathophysiology program. SDSU is a place where you can be a part of a lot of things and still enjoy your time here. Whereas some bigger schools, you might only be able to join one club or organization. SDSU, you can be in a lot of different things and enjoy at the same time. I have a lot of time left, but I'd like to go maybe a clinical or hospital route, something along those lines, just continuing my education. I definitely want to stay in the Midwest. I like the community here, and it's home for me. They're definitely giving me the leadership skills, the communication skills, and just basically being able to be personable with people.
The Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Welcome back to more of this week's Jackrabbit Insider. The SDSU men's basketball team faced its two biggest rivals on the road in Summit League competition Wednesday at North Dakota State and Saturday at South Dakota. Here are the highlights from their two contests on the road. The Jacks started strong in Fargo Wednesday. Mike Dom tallied the first 5 points, including this three. Then Chris Howell with the nice drive, and the game is tied at 8. NDSU took over with an 11-0 run keyed by A.J. Jacobson. The Bison forward posted a double-double, 26 points, and a game-high 12 rebounds. NDSU led by 9 at half. Reed Tellinghuesen scores inside. It was a big week for the co-captain, and then Dom for 3 more. Dom led the Jacks with 26 points on 7 of 17 shooting. He also grabbed 7 rebounds. Tellinghuesen finished with 17 points and 6 boards. Here's one of his 3 triples. And Chris Howell contributed 14. But NDSU remains in first place in the league with an 82-65 win. Saturday in Vermilion, a wild one between the Jacks and Coyotes. USD guard Trey Dickerson hits 2 threes in 20 seconds as USD surges to a 7-point first half lead. Tellinghuesen then hits 2 threes in the span of a minute as SDSU fights back. Later in the half, it's Lane Severin and then Skylar Flatten hitting from deep as SDSU goes up 7. The Jacks made 13 threes and shot 54% from deep. USD retakes the lead 49-43 at half and led by 14 early in the second. Tellinghuesen hits a three to start the rally. And then Severin the physical drive and finish. And back-to-back threes by Tellinghuesen, who established new career highs with 28 points and 8 three-pointers made. He was 11 of 21 from deep in the two games. Jacks take a 2-point lead with under 3 to play when Matt Mooney goes off. The Coyote guard hits 3 straight from deep, and USD up 7. But SDSU isn't done. Dom scored 22 points, 6 rebounds, and a team-high 5 assists. He hits the pull-up 3, and the Jacks close it to 2 with just seconds left. But Tellinghuesen's heave at the buzzer is wide, and USD prevails 91-89. The Summit League on the men's side remains a jumbled mess as far as the standings are concerned. SDSU is tied for 7th, a game ahead of last place, and a game and a half out of 4th place. They'll host IUPUI Wednesday at 7 o'clock at Frost Arena. Join us by visiting jackrabbittickets.com. Highlights of the women's basketball team's 2 Summit League games after we look back at one of the best wrestlers in SDSU history. It's this week's Jackrabbit Legend.
A hard-working kid from Kimball, South Dakota, became a 2-time national champion wrestler. This week's Jackrabbit legend is Paul Konechny, presented by Legend Seeds. He was a five-time place winner in high school, winning 169 matches as a Coyote. He never won a state title, though, a fact that would motivate him to further success at SDSU. He won 33 matches as a freshman, finishing sixth at the NCAA National Duels. That would be the tip of the iceberg. The following year, he went 24-9 and advanced all the way to the national championship match, but fell one win shy of the title. He won 40 matches as a junior, 9 by pinfall, a North Central Conference title. And inside a packed Frost Arena, Konechny won the national championship in front of his own fans. His senior year was his best. He went 40-3 this time and decimated the field en route to a second national title. One of six SDSU wrestlers to earn 4 All-America honors, he won the most matches in program history, 137. Paul Konechny, a Jackrabbit legend. This Jackrabbit legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties!
And we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans. Agronomy, answers, yield.
We love to see you at our games, but don't just show up. Wear yellow and blue. Be proud to show off your Jackrabbit colors.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great. Before we get back to this week's show, here's a look at next week's Insider.
Welcome back to this week's Insider. The South Dakota State women's basketball team is tied for first in the Summit League. And the Jackrabbits hosted Oral Roberts Wednesday and then visited IUPUI on Saturday. Here are the highlights from their two games this week in Summit League competition.
Wednesday was a night where the SDSU women could do no wrong. On Think Pink Night, which raised over $12,000 for the Edith Sanford Breast Foundation, the Jacks scored the first 12 points. State led 21-6 after the first, and Oral Roberts didn't reach double figures until the two-minute mark of the second quarter. SDSU had a 15-0 run in the second and led 42-12 at the break. Clarissa Ober led the way. She had 18 points and 15 rebounds. Carrie Young contributed 18 as well, making 8 of her 9 shots. Ellie Thompson chimed in with 15. And Madison Giebert scored 11. Final, Jacks 82, Oral Roberts 35. Indianapolis is a tough place to play for Summit League opposition, and SDSU battled IUPUI tooth and nail Saturday in the jungle. The Jacks held a slim lead for much of the game as Young paced SDSU with 21 points. Lexi Alexander added 8 points and 9 rebounds, and her bucket with 6:21 to play put SDSU in front 59-54. But the Jacks failed to score the rest of the game. Danielle Lawrence scored 6 of her team-high 20 in the final spurt as the Jaguars tallied the game's last 10 points. And IUPUI defeated SDSU 64-59.
Aaron Johnston's squad is tied with Western Illinois at the top of the Summit League, and SDSU will be in Macomb to take on the Leathernecks on Wednesday night in a first-place showdown in the Summit League standings. We'll have a sophomore student-athlete spotlight on men's basketball's Mike Dom after he relived this moment from the old NCC Holiday Tournament in the Sioux Falls Arena.
Oh, no. To me, sustainability means being able to feed the world in the future.
We need to produce more with less.
It's knowing that our soil is going to be in better shape this year than it was the year before.
We need to stop erosion at the top of the hill, not at the bottom.
We find that we can merge sustainable practices with profitability.
It's about caring for the land.
It's about passing it on to the next generation.
It's about doing the right thing. I have a responsibility.
For the people of South Dakota.
To feed the world.
The future of farming is very bright.
I'm Jeff Lochner.
Steve Halverson.
Al Muron.
This is Farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
Welcome back to The Insider. His Twitter handle is The Dominator, and that's exactly how he performs on the basketball floor. He's only been here 2 years, but what a start to the career it's been for number 24 in men's basketball, Mike Dobb.
The story of this one was The Dominator. SDSU sophomore Mike Dom.
One of the top shooting outside big men in the country.
Dom is a tremendous three-point shooter.
Really the picture of efficiency.
His mom is in the Wyoming Hall of Fame. She's a great basketball player. Dad played football at Wyoming.
You know, Mike Dom, who I watched here, is an outstanding player.
He's had to play 4 minutes. Wow, what a great
finish. What a finish by Dom! Expressing himself.
That's so good. That is spot on.
All laughs aside, Mike Dom has earned quite a reputation for himself over the past 2 years here at South Dakota State. The long-armed assassin from the small town of Kimball, population 2,500 in the southwest corner of Nebraska, currently leads the nation in free throws made, and he's averaging better than 23 points per game, the second most in all of Division I. Remarkable in and of itself. Even more improbable when you retrace his steps. 2 years ago, Dom sat in then head coach Scott Nagy's office, and among the topics during that redshirt season for Dom, would he ever be good enough to even play at South Dakota State?
And I just kind of felt like an outcast on the team at the time. And you know, it was never really a conversation of if I would leave or if I would just stop playing, but there was never like, you're gonna play here someday. It was kind of just, you know, I'll probably just do whatever I can to stay on the team and help the other guys out.
In the last few weeks of his redshirt season, Dom's performance in practice improved. As he worked himself into better shape and spent additional hours in the gym that summer, it became apparent he had earned some playing time. And then he scored double figures 5 times in the Jacks' first 6 games that year.
In times, it just built up where I was put in a position in the game to really help the team out. And I felt like I was able to step up to the challenge, you know, under the direction, the leadership of George, Dre, and Jake, and those guys. And I felt like throughout the season, I just kept building my confidence up. And it just got to a point where I knew I could help the team out, and I think the team counted on me to help them out.
Boy, did they. Dom finished his freshman season averaging a team best 15.2 points per game, while also ranking first on the squad with 6 rebounds a contest. He shot 55% overall, 44 from 3, and 82% at the foul line, earning freshman All-America honors as the Jacks won the Summit League tournament. But shortly thereafter, TJ Otzelberger was hired as the new head coach, and with it, rumors flew as to whether or not Dom would stick around at State.
And then the possibility, everyone's talking, oh, am I going to leave, am I going to stay? And obviously, you know, this was the place for me, so I wanted to stick it out. And then when Coach TJ came in and we got the opportunity to meet him in person, it almost just like clicked, light bulb went off. I mean, he came in energetic. He did his research, knew everything. And I just remember sitting in the team room talking to the guys after, and we all agreed, we're like, if this guy gets the job, then we're gonna have a special season.
When you have an opportunity to do research and you look and you ask people in the league and you ask other coaches and you find out about what a talented player he is, and you watch more film on it, you really learn more about it. And then as you kind of dive into the process, then you hear about his character and what a great teammate he is and how he's just scratching the surface of what type of player he is and can be, it's really exciting. I mean, when you're working in you know, in athletics, especially at the highest level, have a chance to work with, you know, a player who's one of the most talented, certainly offensive players in the country, is it's very intriguing, and it's fun to be his coach.
Whereas last year, Dom was surrounded by senior guards and used primarily as a reserve, this season, with a young backcourt, he became the focal point of the SDSU offense. That also means he's the individual every other team spends the majority of its time preparing for. Dom has responded by establishing a new SDSU sophomore scoring record, and he does it based upon his versatility offensively, described by his coach.
He's so unique because his skill level at 6'9 or 6'10 is really hard to come by. And the fact that he's such a sensational shooter on the perimeter, which I think you've seen more and more as we've progressed in the conference play, he's getting more attempts, but also can score at such a high rate around the basket, over his shoulder, through double teams, and then at the foul line. The numbers he shoots are staggering. You know, in the upper 80s, at times he's been over 90 from the free throw line. It just allows him to score in so many different ways, and that really, you'll see a lot of times great offensive players might have a niche that they're a great shooter or a great low block scorer. Mike fortunately combines a lot of things to make him the unique talent that he is.
You have an opportunity to catch Dom and the rest of the Jackrabbit men's basketball team in Frost Arena Wednesday night as SDSU hosts IUPUI in an important Summit League showdown. That game will take place Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. Visit jackrabbittickets.com to join us. Next week, we'll have senior student athlete spotlights on Clarissa Ober of the women's basketball team and Michael Orris of the men. Plus, we'll look at the new head coach of Jackrabbit soccer, Brock Thompson. So won't you join us then? For all of us inside our Yeager Media Center studios, I'm Tyler Merriam. We'll see you next week on the Jackrabbit Insider.